welcome or welcome back to my channel. Today, I'm back with a video on the search for a mascara that will hold Asian eyelashes. As some of you may or may not know, I have only used one mascara in my whole entire life that has held my lashes all day with a full curl, and that would be Lash Last. I honestly haven't found one that has worked even remotely close to it, so here's the search to finding one that actually works. So today I'm going to be talking about the Marc Jacobs Beauty Box. I got sent this from Influenster to try and review.
So I haven't opened this box yet. It's real nice and sleek. I actually might keep this box. Okay, this is actually more difficult than I thought. Opening with one hand. Here is, looks like a little brochure. It's a new Lash Lengthening and Curling Mascara from Influenster. Here is the inside of the pamphlet. This back of it. Ooh, black tissue paper. Definitely keeping this box. So this is the Marc Jacobs At Lashed in La Cure in number 42. So I just took it out of the box and wow. This is the product. This would be the mascara stick, and it's beautiful. It has black and gold stripes all around it. Feels like pretty good quality, kind of heavy. And also the Marc Jacobs logo is not gonna come off. It's on there pretty good.
This is the brush head. And just for comparison's sake, I'm gonna take out
the CoverGirl one.
So this one is the Marc Jacobs one, and then the Lash Last one looks like this.
So here's a clearer comparison of the two. So you can see Lash Last has a flat surface on top, and then it's curved on the bottom, which you can spin around and use however you'd like. Pretty bulky, but then the Marc Jacobs one is long and slender, and the bristles are not very short. It looks like it's not with that silicone head that Lash Last has.
Okay, so first, obviously, I'm gonna have to curl my eyelashes because they are just stick straight. So what I do with my eyelash curler, I will take it and put all my eyelashes in it, and then I'll turn it 90 degrees clockwise towards my nose and curl it that way, so it gets all the end lashes on this side, and then do the same thing but opposite and curl outward away from my nose, so it gets the inner corner of my lashes. Because I have an almond-shaped eye, sometimes the eyelash curlers that are out there won't get all my lashes, just because my ends and my corners are shorter than my middle part. And you can see a little bit of a difference. This one, you just can't even see my lashes. I swear I have eyelashes, but it's a little bit of a difference. Okay, and there you have it. I am done curling my lashes. Oh, my eyelash curler, I use this from Sally Hansen. I've had this one for like 5 years, and honestly, I think it's one of the best purchases I've ever gotten. It's lasted me so long, and the rubber silicone thing on the inside, you can take that off. The one that I got came with a replacement. I think I just changed it out like 6 months ago, and it's lasted me that long. So definitely worth the purchase. Now for the ultimate test. Normally with mascaras, a lot of them don't hold my curl. So you can see my curl now, and it's pretty curled compared to what it was before. The more I apply mascara, the less my eyelashes would stay like that. So here goes nothing. This tube is so satisfying to look at. I love this thing. It's so pretty. You can see that pretty dramatic between my two eyes. This one has mascara on, this one doesn't, and it looks like it's not really holding the curl. My lashes, they're stick straight, and it's kind of falling from the curl. But let's try the Lash Last in comparison. Okay, now that one is done with application. So this is the before and after of application of two of the different ones. So this one is the Lash Blast, and this one is Marc Jacobs. You can tell the difference, pretty curled. And this one is getting to be stick straight again. Like, you can tell, like, this one's definitely curled, and this one's just like, it just looks like spider legs. There's no curl. literally no curl compared to the other one. So I guess that this was a fail, but this mascara, it definitely has a lot of length. This stuff, I'm gonna put another layer on just because I can. I want to see how long these can get, but volume wise it's not bad. Work pretty well. So if you don't have issues with having a product hold your curl, this is really thick and it won't clump. Wow. I'm gonna try using this with my other one, with the Lash Last as a base. Okay, so definitely works really well as the second coat. So as you can see on this eye, it almost looks like I have false eyelashes on. Almost, but the other eye is completely stick straight. There's no curl at all. You can tell the difference right here. Like there's a curl and all the ones just stick straight. So Lash Boss still winning, but the Marc Jacobs one works really well with length. Surprisingly, and it's not clumping at all. I hope you enjoyed this video, and hopefully this helped you guys a little bit on knowing the differences and going along with my journey of finding the mascara. Let me know if you have any other suggestions of mascara that might work. I'll definitely be glad to try it out. Make sure you hit the bell and turn on notifications for when I upload my next video. Like, comment, and subscribe, and I'll see you next time.